Angus. Call ourselves a community band, DuBois area community band, because we're not just all from DuBois. We have people from Punxsutawney, we have people from over towards Clarion, Brookville, and
St. Mary's.
St. Mary's, yep. And there's one guy who traveled all the way from Boston State, New York. No, Boston. Just to be with us.
That's a community.
Well, actually, he was in the neighborhood. But we like to get together and try to do our best to do a good show on for you guys. Now, to show you how diverse we are, we have father, or husband, wife, two husband, wife groups here. We have mother, daughter. And believe it or not, we have three generations. Of which I am the oldest. And then I have my daughter and my grandson. So we have three generations. We're going to start now.
I'm down in Willow.
Down there for Christmas. And you'll be seeing two people directing tonight.
No, I can't get out of
the reason for this is, neither one of us are 100%. Okay? I spent some quality time in the DuBois Hospital a couple months ago for congestive heart failure. And I managed to beat that. And now my cohort here, who took over for when I couldn't be there, is having a little bit of a problem that she can't play her saxophone. So we decided to just split the duty. So we're going to both be directing different things. And this is Nancy Hill. Nancy? For those of you who don't know me, I'm Dick Trudgeon. I taught music in the DuBois area for 32 years. Then I retired. Boy, what a difference it was. So enjoy, sit back and enjoy. We're going to hopefully have a real good concert for you. But they counted, there's 33 out there. 33. Much bigger than last year when we were here. So, here we go. Before we start, I want six people to stand up. Trumpets. Now, if you see what I see, I thought most of them that the second box would be better for them. Thank you, guys.
No.
All right, there you go.
Thank you. introduced himself. He's the voice of the DuBois Area Community Band. And I get to introduce the song for you that's coming up, and it is called Christmas Declaration. And before we play it, I wanted to ask, did anybody watch the Macy's Day Parade this year? So you saw all the big, you know, the big feelings and the big colorfulness, and did you happen to see the band made up of 400 members, and they were all wearing red blazers? And that band was giving a special accolades to all the band directors in our country, and it was, I think it's called the All-American Band Director Band, and a good friend of mine was marching in the band representing Bedford, Ohio High School. She's the band director there, and it is a privilege to be among a bunch of band directors here. But that feeling of the Macy's Day Parade is the feeling that I hope you'll get in our next tune. It's called Christmas Declaration, and the fellow who wrote it not only wrote for band, he also wrote for drum and bugle corps. His name is Robert W. Smith, and he's from Alabama, also a trumpet player, which I think Dick Trudgeon would cheer him on, also a trumpet player right there. And he's an American composer, arranger, and teacher. And our next piece is Christmas Declaration.
Thank you.
time, if you want to sit down, and a minute to go.
It's been fun to have two conductors. They both have different styles. And, our next piece is called A Christmas Festival, and it's by Leroy Anderson. It was first published in 1950, and this famous work has in it many Christmas carols. And they're all set into a medley, and it is said that this is the Christmas medley upon which all other Christmas medleys are judged. And you'll hear in this one, joy to the world, deck the halls, God rest you merry gentlemen, good King Wenceslas, hark the herald angels sing, silent night, jingle bells, and is it Adeste Fidelis? Adeste Fidelis. So I hope that you'll listen for one of your favorite Christmas carols as we perform for you A Christmas Festival.
Thank you.
in there. You guys, yeah, me too. I love to play that one. So our next song, you might hear on the radio, but it just celebrated, I think, yes it did, its 101st birthday. Carol of the Bells debuted 101 years ago, believe it or not. And it comes from a Ukrainian song, Shchedrik. Did I say it wrong? Shchedrik, thank you. My choral director friend here. And later lyrics were sent to it, so you may remember some of the Sweet Silver Bells or Christmas is Here that announces that Christmas is here. Then it's been played by different people and different groups, and you may have heard it if you've heard the Boston Pops, directed by John Williams. He has an arrangement of it, and the Mannheim Steamroller has an arrangement of it. And maybe on the radio you hear the arrangement by the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. They're a very creative group, and that is what I believe has led up to this arrangement, and it was arranged by David Foster and then has been adapted for concert band by our very own Kenton Scott, who's back in the trombone section back there. And I'm very excited that you did this because I love to listen to it on the radio. And more than that, I love to play it, but I hope that you will love listening to our rendition of Carol of the Bells.
Thank you.
familiar with many of the traditional Christmas carols, and then there are some slightly more contemporary Christmas medleys or melodies, and these are found, a special group of them, in this work called It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year. And these are part of our heritage together. And in this arrangement, you'll hear that Larry Clark has created a lush harmonic setting. And we hope you'll enjoy It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year.
Thank you.
next one involves this guy. So I hope you enjoy this tune as much as I do.
Thank you.
job, Brandon. Stand up. There's your door.
Our next piece you may also hear on the radio these days. It's called Dominic the Donkey, and it's about the Italian Christmas donkey. And you'll hear some folks making donkey singing sounds up here. You're welcome to join in if you would like. And this, Dominic the Donkey, is the donkey who helps Santa deliver presents to Italy. Children in Italy need that extra help because the reindeer can't make it up the hills. But Dominic the Donkey can do those hills and help Santa deliver the presents to kids in Italy. And we thank Italy for this song, and I haven't heard it yet, but in Philly, they've named the song after an area in Philly, in South Philly, where a lot of Italians live, and three of the football players have put together their own rendition of Dominic the Donkey, and apparently they're popular. This is their second album. Who knew? But if you're a Philadelphia Phillies fan, you may want to look up their version of Dominic the Donkey, but this is our version of Dominic the Donkey. Italian Christmas donkey. We hope you enjoy it.
please stand up? And who started that? And I almost forgot that we had a concert, and I wasn't the only one that had a picture on my back. And for several years, we always, and then she went up and called her, darn it. So I was in back visiting, and we have double bridge. You got one bridge with that? Thank you, Lorraine.
Our next piece is the original classic from the TV movie that came out in 1964 about a story about a young reindeer who lives at the North Pole, and his father is one of Santa's reindeer, and it's expected that this young reindeer will eventually be one too. Oh, but he has a feature that is a setback, and it causes him to be ostracized by the other reindeers. It's his red nose. But we find, through the story told with the misfit toys and the bauble, and the elf who wants to be a dentist, and Rudolph himself, that perhaps having a red nose is an asset after all. Be yourself. And we hope that you'll enjoy. This is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Thank you.
Our next song is Hark the Herald Trumpets Swing. And it's thought that if you didn't know any better, you might think that, Miller. Who's the swing guy? By Mark Williams. Now, you might also think that is beginning to look a lot like Christmas right here. And so maybe the song is about us. And it doesn't matter where the trees are, because for us, it's Christmas. So I'll let you ponder that as you enjoy Meredith Wilson's It's Beginning to Look a Lot Like Christmas.
Happy yourself and marry the little person.